Hi, everybody. Welcome to Chinese Pod. This is Joy.
Hi, 大家好，我是 Joshua.
Josh, do you ever go to the post office?
诶，好像我没去过邮局。
What? I go to the post office all the time because I buy stuff and they send it to me, and sometimes I have to send it back.
啊，你说的是网上购物是不是？
That's right.
然后就很多很多的包裹。
Yeah, and they're actually quite heavy too. So, today we're going to talk about going to the post office, sending things, filling out your information.
好，那我们现在来听一下下面这一个对话吧。
你好，我要寄包裹。
这张单子给你，写一下收件人跟寄件人的联络资讯。
好的。
里面有什么？
口罩。
好，我称一下重量。
Welcome back to another installment of Chinese Pod Trivia. And the question for you is, for what test does Chinese Pod offer preparation services for? Is it A, the polygraph, B, the colonoscopy, C, the HSK test, or D, the CAT scan?
The CAT scan?
Ooh, sorry, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, the HSK test.That's right, Chinese Pod will thoroughly prepare you to pass this rigorous test of proficiency in Chinese. ChinesePod.com/HSK.
All right, let's break down the dialogue line by line.
来宾48号，请到4号柜台，谢谢。
Number 48, please go to counter 4. Thank you.
来宾48号。请到四号柜台，谢谢。
Number 48, please go to counter 4. Thank you.
来宾48号，请到四号柜台，谢谢。你好，我要寄包裹。
Hello, I want to send a package.
你好，我要寄包裹。
Hello, I want to send a package.
你好，我要寄包裹。这张单子给你，写一下收件人。跟寄件人的联络资讯。
Here's a form for you. Please fill out the sender and receiver's contact information.
这张单子给你，写一下收件人跟寄件人的联络资讯。
Here's the form for you. Please fill out the sender and receiver's contact information.
这张单子给你，写一下收件人跟寄件人的联络资讯。好的。
All right.
好的。
All right.
好的，里面有什么
？What's inside？
里面有什么
？What's inside？
里面有什么？口罩
，face mask。
口罩
，face mask。
口罩。好，我称一下重量。
Okay, let me weigh to see how heavy it is.
好，我称一下重量。
Okay, let me weigh to see how heavy it is.
好，我称一下重量。我们现在来看看第一个句子。来宾48号请到4号柜台，谢谢。
Yeah, that's what you hear all the time. Every single number is called. So we first start off the sentence with the word guest or visitor, which is...
来宾。那这个字在什么时候常常用呢？
We often use it when we're applauding something. We're like, oh, let's hear it for our esteemed guests, and then we have an applause.
特别是在演唱会
Concerts.
或是节目上
Some kind of show.
会听到像是欢迎各位来宾或者是今天的来宾有谁谁谁这样
when you're introducing or welcoming the guests.
没错。那还有另外一个词是柜台
That's counter.
所以这里的是邮局柜台
post office counter.
那站在邮局柜台后面的是柜台小姐。
We often say front desk lady.
啊，对，其实我们有时候会说前台小姐。
Why is it always a lady?
其实有时候也是先生，但是我们比较常说柜台人员。
Okay, so it's like the person or the clerk at the front desk, or we would just say front desk lady.
或者是柜员这样一个比较常听到的词。
That's a shortened way of saying counter person or service person at the counter.
我们来看看下一个句子。你好，我要寄包裹。
Hello, I want to send a package. So let's first look at that verb send.
是寄。
Okay, that's to mail. And what are we mailing?
是包裹。
A package. Can you break down these two characters?
包和裹的意思一样，都是包起来的意思。
Oh, to wrap up something.
像是包水饺。
Yeah, like wrapping a dumpling.
那我们来看一下包裹这个词。包裹是一个东西，它不是一张纸，也不是信。
Okay, so package to be differentiated from paper or a letter.
那他说寄包裹一定就有收包裹。
So not only can we send a package, we can also receive the package.
没错。那我们再来看看下一个句子。这张单子给你，写一下收件人跟寄件人的联络资讯。
So in the first part, we have the word form, which is
单子。
In the second part, we talk about sender and receiver.
没错，刚刚提了收还有寄，那我们来看一下件这个字。
So that's some kind of document, right?
这就是文件。
Okay, so we're talking about either a physical piece of mail or some kind of package that's received.
那当你在寄东西，在寄包裹或是寄信的时候，你很急，这时候你要选的是急件。
If you're pressed for time, you'd go for the emergency package, which is expensive to mail.
那相反的是普件。
That's regular mail.
就是你不急。所以收件和寄件后面加一个人的意思就是
receiver and sender.
没错。那我们来看下一个词，联络资讯。
That is contact information. So let's break down these two phrases. The first one is contact.
意思就是联络。
We can also add contact person, right?
也就是联络人。
Or contact number.
联络电话。
But in this case, contact info refers to address, phone number, everything.
所以这些包含寄件地址、收件地址的就是联络资讯。
That includes all the addresses of the sender and the receiver.
那寄包裹的时候需要知道里面有什么东西，那重量是多少。所以呢，这里他说的是里面有口罩。
So now we know that there are face masks because you always have to tell them what you're sending.
然后他说要称一下重量。
This is the verb for to weigh, right?
就是称重或是量量看重量的意思。
So to weigh or to measure the weight.
那这个量，比如说我们常说量身高、量体重。
That would be the word for measuring. We can measure our height and weight.
量体重也就是称体重。我来给个例子好了。Joy, 你知道你的体重吗？
Actually, I have no idea.
那你应该要称一下体重。
Okay.
听完这么多，我们再回到刚刚的对话里吧。
你好，我要寄包裹。
这张单子给你，写一下收件人跟寄件人的联络资讯。
好的。
里面有什么？
口罩。
好，我称一下重量。
So, Josh, now you know how to send a package, right?
这边我们说了寄包裹，不过寄信我们没说到哎，所以如果之后我要寄信的话，还是给你寄好了。
Never mind, I'll just do all your mailing for you.
那如果大家对于网上买东西或是寄包裹有什么问题，也欢迎大家问问 Joy。
No, we only accept Chinese questions, which Josh will answer. So if you have any questions or stories you want to share about going to the post office, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks for joining us. I'm Joy.
我是 Josh.
下次见。
拜拜。